What's up everybody, Joris, Hermans here, and today I will show you how I edit my photos National Geographic style. You'll be able to edit yours the same way in less than 5 minutes. Okay guys, first of all, what do I mean by National Geographic style? When I think about National Geographic, I think about the iconic photos we all know, taken by famous photographers like Steve McCurry. The only problem is that most of those photos were shot on film. Now, if you want that film look specifically, just shoot on film, because you can try to simulate it with Photoshop and presets, but it will never look the same. So what I want to show you is how I edit my photos to create that feeling of exploring the world and experiencing cultures. That's what I mean when I say National Geographic style. It's not a film look, but it's adding extra warmth and contrast, atmosphere to your digital photos. And at the end, you can save everything we did in a preset and edit your photos the same way in less than 5 minutes. Now I'm going to use the Camera Raw plugin from Photoshop, but you can do exactly the same in Lightroom, so it doesn't matter what you use. Okay, let's get going. Okay, so I've opened one of my favorite photos from India in Camera Raw, and I'll use this one as an example. We'll start here in the calibration window. Now, this is normally where you set the calibration for your camera, but I found that the settings I use work good for my Pentax camera as well as my Canon cameras. So try it out and see what it does. If it doesn't look good, then skip this step. And I set the reds to 15, saturation minus 5, green primary plus 25, saturation minus 20. The next thing that we need to do is here the HSL adjustments. Here we can change all the colors, the hue, saturation and luminance. Now just follow my lead and put the settings in. You can experiment here, but don't do it too long at a time, because after half an hour you can't see the difference anymore. So here we go. The reds will go for plus 15. We're talking about the hue tab now. Make sure you're in the right tab. The orange is minus 6. We go on. No, I'm sorry. Plus 6. The yellow's minus 5. The green's plus 15. The aqua's 0. The blues will go for plus 5. And the two other sliders we'll leave at 0. Then onto the saturation. The reds we're going for minus 30. The orange is plus 5. The yellow's 0. The green's minus 50. Don't want too much green in there. The aqua's minus 25. The blue's plus 10. The purple's minus 30. And the magenta's minus 30. Then the last tab, the luminance. The red's minus 20, orange is minus 5, yellow's minus 15, the green's minus 10, the aqua's 0, blue's minus 20, and the magenta's minus 15. Okay, that's it for the HSL adjustments. And then we come at the part where the magic happens, the tone curves. Now, there's two different curves, the parametric one and the point curve. For the parametric one, I'll just set a basic slight S curve. Now, you can just use the same settings here. For lights, we set it to 10. And the shadows go to minus 20. And then you see those little triangles here. We're gonna adjust these two. The first one will slide to 18. The second one to 45. There. And the last one to 75. Now the difference between those two curves is the parametric curve is a simple curve where you can adjust the basic highlights, shadows, and midtones of your photo. Now the point curve is where it gets interesting, because there you can change the curve per channel. You can use the red, blue, or green channel and change it accordingly. That's what we're gonna do here. We'll just leave the RGB channel alone and we'll go for the red channel. So what I want to do first is set the same curve for all three channels. You can use the input and output to get exactly the same curves. So we'll start with the first point. Just click on the curve and it will add an anchor point. The first one we'll set at 31, the output at 8. Then create another one. We'll set it at 48 and 19. And then here in the middle, we'll set another one that goes to 114 and 123. And then the last one here goes to 185 and 199. Okay, and we'll do exactly the same for green. First one, 31. Second one, 31, 8. The second point will go for 48, 19. The third point, 114. And 123. And the last one, 185. 185 to 199. Then the blue, exactly the same. First one, 31, 8. Second one, 48, 19. The middle one, 114, 123. And the last one, it's above here, 185 to 199. Now what I want to do is leave the blue and the green the same curve, and I'm going to change the red one slightly. The top point here, I'm going to pull it down a little bit because I don't want too much red in the highlights. So pull it down a little bit. You can also use the input output. Just put it to 179 and 191. Okay, so that's the point curve. It's basically the most important thing of my editing here, because you can change the whole look of your photo by dragging the curve slightly up or down. The whole feel of the photo changes. And now we come to the last part, and that's the basics of the photo. Now we can see here, like, his face is way too dark, so I want to up the exposure a little bit, go to 35 maybe. Then the shadows, because his face is too bright, and maybe also the highlights. Take those down, maybe by a lot, and the contrast maybe a little bit less. And that's it. That's how I like to edit my photos to get this National Geographic style, is what I call it. Now, once you've done all these steps, just save it in a preset. You can do that here. Go to Save Settings. There. Just save it. Give it a name. And then you can use this preset for different photos. I'll show you how. So we have this photo. And we can just apply the preset that we made here. I called it NatGeo. We click on it. You see it's way too dark now. The only thing we have to do now is work with the basics. And we can do everything from here now. You don't need to mess again with the point curves or the parametric curves or all those luminance, saturation and hue settings. Just leave those alone. Just work with the basic settings. For this photo, you'll see it's dark, so I'll go brighter with the exposure. I want it a little bit warmer so we can change the temperature, and maybe also a little bit, and maybe also bring back the shadows a little bit more. And you can use this preset for landscapes, portraits, street photos. It really doesn't matter. I'll show you another example with the photo I took in Kuala Lumpur. Heavily underexposed, by the way, because I wanted the detail in the street sign. So apply the preset, go back to the basics. Let's go for a little bit more exposure and also contrast for this one. A little bit warmer. And maybe for this one, we can up the saturation also a little bit more. There you go. Okay, guys, and that's it. Once you have the preset, it's super easy. Just apply the preset and work with the basic settings. That's all you need to do. Let me know if it works for your photos and see you next time.